Before we start the beta-lactam antibiotic, you must know the name indicated by lactam. So lactam is what? It's simple. The lactams are cyclic amines. Okay. Now this is very important concept to start with. Okay, cyclic amide specifically, you know, it is lactone plus amide, you can say. Now we have a simple amide known as acetamide, CH3CONH2, okay, and over here your nitrogen is ideally sp2 hybridized, and it can donate its lone pair and it undergo a resonating process. But now if we draw the lactam ring, like you have your beta lactam. Why beta? Because adjacent to carbonyl is alpha and then beta. Okay, beta lactam. Or you have maybe the 7-member ring, which is like this, and you have also alpha, beta, gamma, delta, epsilon. So this is known as beta lactam. This is caprolactam. This can be also a nitro question. So lactam is nothing but a cyclic amide. So now, because of their cyclic nature, it is very difficult for them into resonance. Okay. So if you see, because of the ring strength, the beta lactam cannot exhibit ideal resonance as per sp2. So ring strain present in beta lactam ring. Okay, so and this change their reactivity. So that's very important, because all pharmaceutical agents are reactive to their targets. Okay, now how to synthesize beta lactam? We have a good Nipper question. It is break pot synthesis. BRECK, break pot synthesis. Otherwise, you can use lactam, can be synthesized by Beckmann rearrangement, then Schmidt rearrangement. And lactams, the very useful application of lactams, they can be easily polymerized to polyamides. Okay, so now we talk about reactivity. Let us go with the concept. Reactivity. Okay, now the moment we are talking about reactivity, if you see in sp2 hybridized atom, the nitrogen supposed to be a trigonal planar geometry. Trigonal planar geometry. But whenever it's confined into the ring, A pyramidal geometry is imposed. Okay, so that means basically the nitrogen of amide wants to be in trigonal planar condition, but because of the ring strain, because of the ring configuration structure, they are forced to adopt a pyramidal structure. Now if you see, a pyramid always have a base and an apex. Okay, and over here it is nitrogen, so this is your base, and that's also contain a height. So these heights actually help us to understand the reactivity of beta lactams. Now normally beta lactams are not alone. You have beta lactam in combination with a heterocyclic ring. It can be a 5-member, okay, known as penum. Now penum, the height is 0.40 to 0.50, the height of the apex to base, 0.40 to 0.50 angstrom. Okay, this is penum. Now then next we have cepheme, that is your beta lactam with 6 member. Now because of double bond we call them cepheme. Okay, E, otherwise we would have called cepheme. Now for cepheme the height is almost 0.20 to 0.20 to 0.25 angstrom. Okay, then if I replace sulfur with a carbon, then pinum become carbapenem. Okay, so we have carbapenem structure. This is carbapenem. If we add double bond, it become carbapenem, right? Because again the double bond introduce the structure, the letter E. Now for carbapenem we have the H is 0.50 to 0.60 angstrom, right? Then you have oxapenem. Oxapenem, again sulfur we replace with oxygen, so we have this little lactam with an oxygen